A gas turbine, also called a combustion turbine, is a type of internal combustion engine. It is an upstream rotating compressor coupled to a downstream turbine, and a combustion chamber in between. The basic operation of the gas turbine is similar to that of the steam power plant, except that air is used instead of water. Fresh atmospheric air flows through a compressor that brings it to higher pressure. Energy is then added by spraying fuel into the air and igniting it, so the combustion generates a high temperature flow. This high temperature, high pressure gas enters a turbine, where it expands down to the exhaust pressure, producing a shaft work output in the process. The turbine shaft work is used to drive the compressor and other devices, such as an electric generator that may be coupled to the shaft. The energy that is not used for shaft work comes out in the exhaust gases, so these have either a high temperature or a high velocity. The purpose of the gas turbine determines the design so that the most desirable energy form is maximized. Gas turbines are used to power aircraft, trains, ships, electrical generators, or even tanks. History, 50, Heroes Engineer Euro. Apparently, Heroes steam engine was taken to be no more than a toy, and thus its full potential not realized for centuries. 1500, the chimney jack was drawn by Leonardo da Vinci. Hot air from a fire rises through a single-stage axial turbine rotor mounted in the exhaust duct of the fireplace and turning the roasting spit by gear/chain connection. 1629, jets of steam rotated an impulse turbine that then drove a working stamping mill by means of a bevel gear, developed by Giovanni Branca. 1678, Ferdinand Verbiest built a model carriage relying on a steam jet for power. 1791, a patent was given to John Barber, an Englishman, for the first true gas turbine. His invention had most of the elements present in the modern-day gas turbines. The turbine was designed to power a horseless carriage. 1872, a gas turbine engine was designed by Franz Stolze, but the engine never ran under its own power. 1894, Sir Charles Parsons patented the idea of propelling a ship with a steam turbine, and built a demonstration vessel, the turbine, easily the fastest vessel afloat at the time. This principle of propulsion is still of some use. 1895, 3 4-ton 100 kilowatt Parsons radial flow generators were installed in Cambridge Power Station, and used to power the first electric street lighting scheme in the city. 1899, Charles Gordon Curtis patented the first gas turbine engine in the USA. 1900, Sanford Alexander Moss submitted a thesis on gas turbines. In 1903, Moss became an engineer for General Electric Steam Turbine Department in Lynn, Massachusetts. While there, he applied some of his concepts in the development of the turbo supercharger. His design used a small turbine wheel, driven by exhaust gases, to turn a supercharger. 1903, a Norwegian, Egidius Elling, was able to build the first gas turbine that was able to produce more power than needed to run its own components, which was considered an achievement in a time when knowledge about aerodynamics was limited. Using rotary compressors in turbines, it produced 11 HP. 1906, the Armgord Lamelle turbine engine in France with water-cooled combustion chamber. 1910, Holzath impulse turbine achieved 150 kilowatts. 1913, Nikola Tesla patents the Tesla turbine based on the boundary layer effect. 1920s, the practical theory of gas flow through passages was developed into the more formal theory of gas flow past airfoils by A.A. Griffith, resulting in the publishing in 1926 of an aerodynamic theory of turbine design. Working testbed designs of axial turbines suitable for driving a propeller were developed by the Royal Aeronautical Establishment, proving the efficiency of aerodynamic shaping of their blades in 1929. 1930, having found no interest from the RAF for his idea, Frank Whittle patented the design for a centrifugal gas turbine for jet propulsion. The first successful use of his engine was in April 1937. 1932, BBC Brown, Bavarian Sea of Switzerland, starts selling axial compressor and turbine to Bossitz as part of the turbocharged steam-generating Velox boiler. Following the gas turbine principle, the steam evaporation tubes are arranged within the gas turbine combustion chamber. The first Velox plant was erected in Mondeville, France. 1934, Roy L. Porteras de Pescara patented the free piston engine as a gas generator for gas turbines. 1936, Hans von Owen and Max Hahn in Germany were developing their own patented engine design. 1936, Whittle with others backed by investment firms Power Jets Limited. 1937, the first Power Jets engine runs, and impresses Henrik Zid such that he secures government funding for its further development. 1939, first 4MW utility power generation gas turbine from BBC Brown, Bavarian Sea for an emergency power station in Neuchâtel, Switzerland. 1946, national gas turbine establishment formed from Power Jets in the RAE turbine division bring together Whittle and Hain Constant's work, theory of operation. In an ideal gas turbine, gases undergo three thermodynamic processes, an isentropic compression, an isobaric combustion and an isentropic expansion. Together, these make up the Brayton cycle. In a practical gas turbine, mechanical energy is irreversibly transformed into heat when gases are compressed, due to internal friction and turbulence. Passage through the combustion chamber, where heat is added and the specific volume of the gases increases, is accompanied by a slight loss in pressure. During expansion amidst the stator and rotor blades of the turbine, irreversible energy transformation once again occurs. If the device has been designed to power a shaft as with an industrial generator or a turboprop, the exit pressure will be as close to the entry pressure as possible. In practice, it is necessary that some pressure remains at the outlet in order to fully expel the exhaust gases. In the case of a jet engine, only enough pressure and energy is extracted from the flow to drive the compressor and other components. The remaining high-pressure gases are accelerated to provide a jet that can, for example, be used to propel an aircraft. As with all cyclic heat engines, higher combustion temperatures can allow for greater efficiencies. However, temperatures are limited by ability of the steel, nickel, ceramic, or other materials that make up the engine to withstand high temperatures and stresses. To combat this, many turbines feature complex blade cooling systems. As a general rule, the smaller the engine, the higher the rotation rate of the shaft, S, must be to maintain tip speed. Blade tip speed determines the maximum pressure ratios that can be obtained by the turbine and the compressor. This, in turn, limits the maximum power and efficiency that can be obtained by the engine. In order for tip speed to remain constant, if the diameter of a rotor is reduced by half, the rotational speed must double. For example, large jet engines operate around 10,000 RPMs, while microturbines spin as fast as 500,000 RPMs. Mechanically, gas turbines can be considerably less complex than internal combustion piston engines. Simple turbines might have one moving part, the shaft turbine alternative rotor assembly, not counting the fuel system. However, the required precision manufacturing for components and temperature-resistant alloys necessary for high efficiency often make the construction of a simple turbine more complicated than piston engines. More sophisticated turbines may have multiple shafts, hundreds of turbine blades, movable stator blades, and a vast system of complex piping, combustors and heat exchangers. Thrust bearings and journal bearings are a critical part of design. Traditionally, they have been hydrodynamic oil bearings, or oil-cooled ball bearings. These bearings are being surpassed by foil bearings, which have been successfully used in microturbines and auxiliary power units. Types of gas turbines, jet engines. Air-breathing jet engines are gas turbines optimized to produce thrust from the exhaust gases, or from ducted fans connected to the gas turbines. Jet engines that produce thrust from the direct impulse of exhaust gases are often called turbojets, whereas those that generate thrust with the addition of a ducted fan are often called turbofans or fan jets. Gas turbines are also used in many liquid propellant rockets. The gas turbines are used to power a turbo pump to permit the use of lightweight, low-pressure tanks, which saves considerable dry mass. Turboprop engines. A turboprop engine is a type of turbine engine which drives an external aircraft propeller using a reduction gear. Turboprop engines are generally used on small subsonic aircraft, but some large military and civil aircraft, such as the Airbus A400M, Lockheed L-188 Electra and Tupolev Tu-95, have also used turboprop power. Aeroderivative gas turbines. Aeroderivatives are also used in electrical power generation due to their ability to be shut down and handle load changes more quickly than industrial machines. They are also used in the marine industry to reduce weight. The General Electric LM2500, General Electric LM6000, Rolls-Royce RB211 and Rolls-Royce Avon are common models of this type of machine. Amateur gas turbines. Increasing numbers of gas turbines are being used or even constructed by amateurs. In its most straightforward form, these are commercial turbines acquired through military surplus or scrapyard sales, then operated for display as part of the hobby of engine collecting. In its most extreme form, amateurs have even rebuilt engines beyond professional repair and then used them to compete for the land speed record. The simplest form of self-constructed gas turbine employs an automotive turbocharger as the core component. A combustion chamber is fabricated and plumbed between the compressor and turbine sections. More sophisticated turbojets are also built, where their thrust and lightweight are sufficient to power large model aircraft. The Schreckling design constructs the entire engine from raw materials, including the fabrication of a centrifugal compressor wheel from plywood, epoxy and wrapped carbon fiber strands. Several small companies now manufacture small turbines and parts for the amateur. Most turbojet-powered model aircraft are now using these commercial and semi-commercial micro-turbines, rather than a Schreckling-like home build. Auxiliary power units, APUs are small gas turbines designed to supply auxiliary power to larger, mobile, machines such as an aircraft. They supply compressed air for air conditioning and ventilation, compressed air startup power for larger jet engines, mechanical power to a gearbox to drive shafted accessories or to start large jet engines, and electrical, hydraulic and other power transmission sources to consuming devices remote from the APU. Industrial gas turbines for power generation. Industrial gas turbines differ from aeronautical designs in that the frames, bearings, and blading are of heavier construction. They are also much more closely integrated with the devices they power, often an electric generator, and the secondary energy equipment that is used to recover residual energy. They range in size from man-portable mobile plants to enormous, complex systems weighing more than 100 tons housed in block-sized buildings. When the turbine is used solely for shaft power, its thermal efficiency is around the 30% mark. This may cause a problem in which it is cheaper to buy electricity than to burn fuel. Therefore, many engines are used in CHP configurations that can be small enough to be integrated into portable container configurations. Gas turbines can be particularly efficient up to at least 60% when waste heat from the turbine is recovered by a heat recovery steam generator to power a conventional steam turbine in a combined cycle configuration. They can also be run in a cogeneration configuration, the exhaust is used for space or water heating, or drives an absorption chiller for cooling the inlet air and increase the power output, technology known as turbine inlet air cooling. Another significant advantage is their ability to be turned on and off within minutes, supplying power during peak, or unscheduled, demand. Since single-cycle power plants are less efficient than combined-cycle plants, they are usually used as peaking power plants, which operate anywhere from several hours per day to a few dozen hours per year depending on the electricity demand and the generating capacity of the region. In areas with a shortage of base load and load following power plant capacity or with low fuel costs, a gas turbine power plant may regularly operate most hours of the day. A large single-cycle gas turbine typically produces 100 to 400 megawatts of electric power and has 35-40% thermal efficiency. Industrial gas turbines for mechanical drive. Industrial gas turbines that are used solely for mechanical drive or used in collaboration with a recovery steam generator differ from power generating sets in that they are often smaller and feature a dual shaft design as opposed to single shaft. The power range varies from 1 megawatt up to 50 megawatts. These engines are connected directly or via a gearbox to either a pump or compressor assembly. The majority of installations are used within the oil and gas industries. Mechanical drive applications increase efficiency by around 2%. Oil and gas platforms require these engines to drive compressors to inject gas into the wells to force oil up via another bore, or to compress the gas for transportation. They're also often used to provide power for the platform. These platforms don't need to use the engine in collaboration with a CHP system due to getting the gas at an extremely reduced cost. The same companies use pump sets to drive the fluids to land and across pipelines in various intervals. Compressed air energy storage. One modern development seeks to improve efficiency in another way, by separating the compressor and the turbine with a compressed air store. In a conventional turbine, up to half the generated power is used driving the compressor. In a compressed air energy storage configuration, power, perhaps from a wind farm or bought on the open market at a time of low demand and low price, is used to drive the compressor, and the compressed air released to operate the turbine when required. Turboshaft engines. Turboshaft engines are often used to drive compression trains and are used to power almost all modern helicopters. The primary shaft bears the compressor and the high-speed turbine, while a second shaft bears the low-speed turbine. In effect, the separation of the gas generator, by a fluid coupling, from the power turbine is analogous to an automotive transmission's fluid coupling. This arrangement is used to increase power output flexibility with associated highly reliable control mechanisms. Radial gas turbines. In 1963, Jan Mobil initiated the development at Kongsberg via Jenpin fabric in Norway. Various successors have made good progress in the refinement of this mechanism. Owing to a configuration that keeps heat away from certain bearings, the durability of the machine is improved while the radial turbine is well matched in speed requirement. Scale jet engines. Also known as miniature gas turbines or microjets. With this in mind, the pioneer of modern microjets, Kurt Schreckling, produced one of the world's first microturbines, the FD3/67. This engine can produce up to 22 newtons of thrust, and can be built by most mechanically minded people with basic engineering tools, such as a metal lathe. Microturbines, also known as turbo alternators, turbo generator, microturbines are touted to become widespread in distributed power and combined heat and power applications. They are one of the most promising technologies for powering hybrid electric vehicles. They range from handheld units producing less than a kilowatt, to commercial-sized systems that produce tens or hundreds of kilowatts. Basic principles of microturbine are based on microcombustion. Part of their claimed success is said to be due to advances in electronics, which allows unattended operation and interfacing with the commercial power grid. Electronic power switching technology eliminates the need for the generator to be synchronized with the power grid. This allows the generator to be integrated with the turbine shaft, and to double as the starter motor. Microturbine systems have many claimed advantages over reciprocating engine generators, such as higher power-to-weight ratio, low emissions and few, or just one, moving part. Advantages are that microturbines may be designed with foil bearings and air cooling operating without lubricating oil, coolants or other hazardous materials. Nevertheless, reciprocating engines overall are still cheaper when all factors are considered. Microturbines also have a further advantage of having the majority of the waste heat contained in the relatively high temperature exhaust, making it simpler to capture, whereas the waste heat of reciprocating engines is split between its exhaust and cooling system. However, reciprocating engine generators are quicker to respond to changes in output power requirement and are usually slightly more efficient, although the efficiency of microturbines is increasing. Microturbines also lose more efficiency at low power levels than reciprocating engines. Reciprocating engines typically use simple motor oil bearings. Full-size gas turbines often use ball bearings. The 1000 degrees Celsius temperatures and high speeds of microturbines make oil lubrication and ball bearings impractical. They require air bearings or possibly magnetic bearings. When used in extended-range electric vehicles, the static efficiency drawback is irrelevant, Since the gas turbine can be run at or near maximum power, driving an alternator to produce electricity either for the wheel motors, or for the batteries, as appropriate to speed and battery state. The batteries act as a buffer in delivering the required amount of power to the wheel motors, rendering throttle response of the gas turbine completely irrelevant. There is, moreover, no need for a significant or variable speed gearbox. Turning an alternator at comparatively high speeds allows for a smaller and lighter alternator than would otherwise be the case. The superior power-to-weight ratio of the gas turbine and its fixed-speed gearbox allows for a much lighter prime mover than those in such hybrids as the Toyota Prius or the Chevrolet Volt. This in turn allows a heavier weight of batteries to be carried, which allows for a longer electric-only range. Alternatively, the vehicle can use heavier types of batteries such as lead-acid batteries or safer types of batteries such as lithium iron phosphate. When gas turbines are used in extended-range electric vehicles, like those planned by Land Rover Range Rover in conjunction with Bledon, or by Jaguar also in partnership with Bledon, the very poor throttling response does not matter, because the gas turbine, which may be spinning at 100,000 RPMs, is not directly, mechanically connected to the wheels. It was this poor throttling response that so bedeviled the 1960 Rover gas turbine-powered prototype motor car, which did not have the advantage of an intermediate electric drivetrain. Gas turbines accept most commercial fuels, such as petrol, natural gas, propane, diesel, and kerosene, as well as renewable fuels such as E85, biodiesel and biogas. However, when running on kerosene or diesel, starting sometimes requires the assistance of a more volatile product such as propane gas, although the new Kero Start technology can allow even microturbines fueled on kerosene to start without propane. Microturbine designs usually consist of a single-stage radial compressor, a single-stage radial turbine and a recuperator. Recuperators are difficult to design and manufacture because they operate under high pressure and temperature differentials. Exhaust heat can be used for water heating, space heating, drying processes or absorption chillers, which create cold for air conditioning from heat energy instead of electric energy. Typical microturbine efficiencies are 25 to 35%. When in a combined heat and power cogeneration system, efficiencies of greater than 80% are commonly achieved. MIT started its millimeter-sized turbine engine project in the middle of the 1990s when Professor of Aeronautics and Astronautics Alan H. Epstein considered the possibility of creating a personal turbine which will be able to meet all the demands of a modern person's electrical needs, just as a large turbine can meet the electricity demands of a small city. Problems have occurred with heat dissipation and high-speed bearings in these new microturbines. Moreover, their expected efficiency is a very low 5 to 6%. According to Professor Epstein, current commercial lithium-ion rechargeable batteries deliver about 120 to 150 Wh per kilogram. MIT's millimeter-sized turbine will deliver 500 to 700 Wh per kilogram in the near term, rising to 1200 to 1500 Wh on registered trademark hour per kilogram in the longer term. A similar microturbine built in Belgium has a rotor diameter of 20 mm and is expected to produce about 1000 W. External combustion. Most gas turbines are internal combustion engines, but it is also possible to manufacture an external combustion gas turbine, which is, effectively, a turbine version of a hot air engine. Those systems are usually indicated as EFGT or IFGT. External combustion has been used for the purpose of using pulverized coal or finely ground biomass as a fuel. In the indirect system, a heat exchanger is used and only clean air with no combustion products travels through the power turbine. The thermal efficiency is lower in the indirect type of external combustion. However, the turbine blades are not subjected to combustion products and much lower quality fuels are able to be used. When external combustion is used, it is possible to use exhaust air from the turbine as the primary combustion air. This effectively reduces global heat losses, although heat losses associated with the combustion exhaust remain inevitable. Closed-cycle gas turbines based on helium or supercritical carbon dioxide also hold promise for use with future high-temperature solar and nuclear power generation. gas turbines and surface vehicles. Gas turbines are often used on ships, locomotives, helicopters, tanks, and to a lesser extent, on cars, buses, and motorcycles. A key advantage of jets and turboprops for aeroplane propulsion, their superior performance at high altitude compared to piston engines, particularly naturally aspirated ones, is irrelevant in most automobile applications. Their power-to-weight advantage, though less critical than for aircraft, is still important. Gas turbines offer a high-powered engine in a very small and light package. However, they are not as responsive and efficient as small piston engines over the wide range of RPMs and powers needed in vehicle applications. In series hybrid vehicles, as the driving electric motors are mechanically detached from the electricity-generating engine, the responsiveness, poor performance at low speed and low efficiency at low output problems are much less important. The turbine can be run at optimum speed for its power output, and batteries and ultracapacitors can supply power as needed, with the engine cycled on and off to run it only at high efficiency. The emergence of the continuously variable transmission may also alleviate the responsiveness problem. Turbines have historically been more expensive to produce than piston engines, though this is partly because piston engines have been mass-produced in huge quantities for decades, while small gas turbine engines are rarities. However, turbines are mass-produced in the closely related form of the turbocharger. The turbocharger is basically a compact and simple free-shaft radial gas turbine which is driven by the piston engine's exhaust gas. The centripetal turbine wheel drives a centrifugal compressor wheel through a common rotating shaft. This wheel supercharges the engine air intake to a degree that can be controlled by means of a wastegate or by dynamically modifying the turbine housing's geometry. It mainly serves as a power recovery device which converts a great deal of otherwise wasted thermal and kinetic energy into engine boost. Turbo compound engines are fitted with blowdown turbines which are similar in design and appearance to a turbocharger except for the turbine shaft being mechanically or hydraulically connected to the engine's crankshaft instead of to a centrifugal compressor, thus providing additional power instead of boost. While the turbocharger is a pressure turbine, a power recovery turbine is a velocity one. Passenger road vehicles, a number of experiments have been conducted with gas turbine-powered automobiles, the largest by Chrysler. More recently, there has been some interest in the use of turbine engines for hybrid electric cars. For instance, a consortium led by micro gas turbine company Blidon Jets has secured investment from the Technology Strategy Board to develop an ultra-lightweight range extender for next-generation electric vehicles. The objective of the consortium, which includes luxury car maker Jaguar Land Rover and leading electrical machine company Senior Drives, is to produce the world a Euro 1 registered trademark S first commercially viable and environmentally friendly gas turbine generator designed specifically for automotive applications. The common turbocharger for gasoline or diesel engines is also a turbine derivative. Concept cars, the first serious investigation of using a gas turbine in cars was in 1946 when two engineers, Robert Kafka and Robert Enkestein of Carney Associates, a New York engineering firm, came up with the concept where a unique compact turbine engine design would provide power for a rear-wheel drive car. After an article appeared in Popular Science, there was no further work beyond the paper stage. In 1950, designer F. Abel and chief engineer Maurice Wilkes from British car manufacturers Rover unveiled the first car powered with a gas turbine engine. The two-seater JET1 had the engine positioned behind the seats, air intake grills on either side of the car, and exhaust outlets on the top of the tail. During tests, the car reached top speeds of 140 km per hour, at a turbine speed of 50,000 rpm. The car ran on petrol, paraffin or diesel oil, but fuel consumption problems proved insurmountable for a production car. It is on display at the London Science Museum. The first turbine-powered car built in the US was the GM Firebird I, which began evaluations in 1953. While the photos of the Firebird I would indicate that the jet turbine's thrust propelled the car like an aircraft, the turbine in fact drove the rear wheels. The Firebird 1 was never meant as a serious commercial passenger car and was solely built for testing and evaluation and public relation purposes. Starting in 1954 with a modified Plymouth, the American car manufacturer Chrysler demonstrated several prototype gas turbine-powered cars from the early 1950s through the early 1980s. Chrysler built 50 Chrysler turbine cars in 1963 and conducted the only consumer trial of gas turbine-powered cars. Each of their turbines employed a unique rotating recuperator, referred to as a regenerator, that significantly increased efficiency. In 1954, Fiat unveiled a concept car with a turbine engine called Fiat Turbina. This vehicle, looking like an aircraft with wheels, used a unique combination of both jet thrust and the engine driving the wheels. Speeds of 282 km per hour were claimed. The original General Motors Firebird was a series of concept cars developed for the 1953, 1956 and 1959 Motorama auto shows, powered by gas turbines. Toyota demonstrated several gas turbine-powered concept cars such as the Century gas turbine hybrid in 1975, the Sports 800 gas turbine hybrid in 1979 and the GTV in 1985. No production vehicles were made. The GT24 engine was exhibited in 1977 without a vehicle. The fictional Batmobile is often said to be powered by a gas turbine or a jet engine. The 1960s television show vehicle was said to be powered by a turbine engine, with a parachute braking system. For the 1989 Batman film, the production department built a working turbine vehicle for the Batmobile prop. Its fuel capacity, however, was reportedly only enough for 15 seconds of use at a time. In the early 1990s, Volvo introduced the Volvo Environmental Concept Car, ECC, which was a gas turbine-powered hybrid car. In 1993, General Motors introduced the first commercial gas turbine-powered hybrid vehicle. Euro was a limited production run of the EV1 series hybrid. A Williams International 40-kilowatt turbine drove an alternator which powered the battery electric powertrain. The turbine design included a recuperator. Later on in 2006, GM went into the ECO jet concept car project with Jay Leno. At the 2010 Paris Motor Show, Jaguar demonstrated its Jaguar CX75 concept car. This electrically powered supercar has a top speed of 204 mph per hour and can go from 0 to 62 mph per hour in 3.4 seconds. It uses lithium-ion batteries to power four electric motors which combine to produce some 780 bhp. It will do around 100 miles on a single charge of the batteries, but in addition it uses a pair of Blidom micro gas turbines to recharge the batteries, extending the range to some 560 miles. Racing cars. The first race car fitted with a turbine was in 1955 by a U.S. Air Force group as a hobby project, with a turbine loaned them by Boeing and a race car owned by Firestone Tire and Rubber Company. The first race car fitted with a turbine for the goal of actual racing was by Rover, and the BRM Formula One team joined forces to produce the Rover BRM, a gas turbine-powered coupe, which entered the 1963 24 Hours of Le Mans, driven by Graham Hill and Richie Ginther. It averaged 107.8 mph per hour and had a top speed of 142 mph per hour. American Ray Hoppenstall joined Homet Corporation and McKee Engineering together to develop their own gas turbine sports car in 1968, the Homet TX, which ran several American and European events, including two wins, and also participated in the 1968 24 Hours of Le Mans. The cars used Continental gas turbines, which eventually set six FIA land speed records for turbine-powered cars. For open-wheel racing, 1967's revolutionary STP Paxton turbo car, fielded by racing and entrepreneurial legend Andy Granatelli and driven by Parnelly Jones, nearly won the Indianapolis 500. The Pratt & Whitney ST6B62-powered turbine car was almost a lap ahead of the second-place car when a gearbox bearing failed just three laps from the finish line. Your next year, the STP Lotus 56 turbine car won the Indianapolis 500 pole position, even though new rules restricted the air intake dramatically. In 1971, Lotus principal Colin Chapman introduced the Lotus 56 BF1 car, powered by a Pratt & Whitney Station 6/76 gas turbine. Chapman had a reputation of building radical championship-winning cars, but had to abandon the project because there were too many problems with turbo lag. Buses, the arrival of the Capstone microturbine has led to several hybrid bus designs, starting with HEV1 by AVS of Chattanooga, Tennessee in 1999, and closely followed by Bus and ISE Research in California, and Design Line Corporation in New Zealand. AVS turbine hybrids were plagued with reliability and quality control problems, resulting in liquidation of AVS in 2003. The most successful design by Design Line is now operated in 5 cities in 6 countries, with over 30 buses in operation worldwide, and order for several hundred being delivered to Baltimore and NYC. Brescia, Italy is using serial hybrid buses powered by microturbines on routes through the historical sections of the city. Motorcycles, the MTT turbine superbike appeared in 2000 and is the first production motorcycle powered by a turbine engine, specifically, a Rolls-Royce Allison Model 250 turbo shaft engine, producing about 283 a kilowatt. Speed tested to 365 a kilometer per hour or 227 a mile per hour, it holds the Guinness World Record for most powerful production motorcycle and most expensive production motorcycle, with a price tag of $185,000. Trains. Several locomotive classes have been powered by gas turbines, the most recent incarnation being Bombardier's jet train. Tanks. The German Army's development division, the Heere Swaffenamt, studied a number of gas turbine engines for use in tanks starting in mid-1944. The first gas turbine engines used for armored fighting vehicle GT-101 was installed in the Panther tank. The second use of a gas turbine in an armored fighting vehicle was in 1954 when a unit, PU-2979, specifically developed for tanks by C.A. Parsons and Company, was installed and trialed in a British Conqueror tank. The Stridsvagn 103 was developed in the 1950s and was the first mass-produced main battle tank to use a turbine engine. Since then, gas turbine engines have been used as APUs in some tanks and as main power plants in Soviet Russian T-80s and US M1 Abrams tanks, among others. They are lighter and smaller than diesels at the same sustained power output, but the models installed to date are less fuel efficient than the equivalent diesel, especially at idle, requiring more fuel to achieve the same combat range. Successive models of M1 have addressed this problem with battery packs or secondary generators to power the tank systems while stationary, saving fuel by reducing the need to idle the main turbine. T-80s can mount 3 large external fuel drums to extend their range. Russia has stopped production of the T-80 in favor of the diesel-powered T-90, while Ukraine has developed the diesel-powered T-80UD and T-84 with nearly the power of the gas turbine tank. The French Lecoq MBT's diesel power plant features the Hyperbar hybrid supercharging system, where the engine's turbocharger is completely replaced with a small gas turbine which also works as an assisted diesel exhaust turbocharger, enabling engine RPM independent boost level control and a higher peak boost pressure to be reached. This system allows a smaller displacement and lighter engine to be used as the tank's power plant and effectively removes turbo lag. This special gas turbine turbocharger can also work independently from the main engine as an ordinary APU. A turbine is theoretically more reliable and easier to maintain than a piston engine, since it has a simpler construction with fewer moving parts, but in practice turbine parts experience a higher wear rate due to their higher working speeds. The turbine blades are highly sensitive to dust and fine sand, so that in desert operations air filters have to be fitted and changed several times daily. An improperly fitted filter, or a bullet or shell fragment that punctures the filter, can damage the engine. Piston engines also need well-maintained filters, but they are more resilient if the filter does fail. Like most modern diesel engines used in tanks, gas turbines are usually multi-fuel engines. Marine applications, naval. Gas turbines are used in many naval vessels, where they are valued for their high power-to-weight ratio and their ship's resulting acceleration and ability to get underway quickly. The first gas turbine-powered naval vessel was the Royal Navy's motor gun boat MGB 2009, converted in 1947. Metropolitan Vickers fitted their F2/3 jet engine with a power turbine. The steam gunboat Grey Goose was converted to Rolls-Royce gas turbines in 1952 and operated as such from 1953. The Bold-class fast patrol boats Bold Pioneer and Bold Pathfinder, built in 1953, were the first ships created specifically for gas turbine propulsion. The first large-scale, partially gas turbine-powered ships were the Royal Navy's Type 81 frigates with combined steam and gas power plants. The first, HMS Ashanti, was commissioned in 1961. The German Navy launched the first Car Paragraph LN-class frigate in 1961 with two Brown, Bavarian Sea gas turbines and the world's first combined diesel and gas propulsion system. The Danish Navy had six Zarlaven-class torpedo boats in service from 1965 to 1990, which had three Bristol Proteus marine gas turbines rated at 9,510 a kilowatt combined, plus two General Motors diesel engines, rated at 340 a kilowatt, for better fuel economy at slower speeds. And they also produced 10 Alamos-class torpedo-slash-guided missile boats, which are three Rolls-Royce Marine Proteus gas turbines also rated at 9,510 a kilowatt, same as the Zarlaven-class boats, and two General Motors diesel engines, rated at 600 a kilowatt, also for improved fuel economy at slow speeds. The Swedish Navy produced six Spica-class torpedo boats between 1966 and 1967, powered by three Bristol Siddeley Proteus 1282 turbines, each delivering 3,210 a kilowatt. They were later joined by 12 upgraded NORAKA Paragraph Pink-class ships, still with the same engines. With their aft torpedo tubes replaced by anti-shipping missiles, they served as missile boats until the last was retired in 2005. The Finnish Navy commissioned two Churunma-class corvettes, Churunma and Kajala, in 1968. They were equipped with one 16,410 a kilowatt Rolls-Royce Olympus TMB3 gas turbine and three WA Currency RTSILA Currency marine diesels for slower speeds. They were the fastest vessels in the Finnish Navy. They regularly achieved speeds of 35 knots and 37.3 knots during sea trials. The Churunmas were paid off in 2002. Kajala is today a museum ship in Turku, and Churunma serves as a floating machine shop and training ship for Satakunta Polytechnical College. The next series of major naval vessels were the four Canadian Iroquois-class helicopter-carrying destroyers, first commissioned in 1972. They used two FT-4 main propulsion engines, two FT-12 cruise engines and three Solar Saturn 750 a kilowatt generators. The first U.S. gas turbine-powered ship was the U.S. Coast Guard's Point Thatcher, a cutter commissioned in 1961 that was powered by two 750 a kilowatt turbines utilizing controllable pitch propellers. The larger Hamilton-class high-endurance cutters was the first class of larger cutters to utilize gas turbines, the first of which was commissioned in 1967. Since then, they have powered the U.S. Navy's Perry-class frigates, Spruance-class and Islay Burke-class destroyers, and Ticonderoga-class guided missile cruisers. USS Marquin Island, a modified WASP-class amphibious assault ship, is to be the Navy's first amphibious assault ship powered by gas turbines. The marine gas turbine operates in a more corrosive atmosphere due to presence of sea salt in air and fuel and use of cheaper fuels. Civilian maritime, up to the late 1940s, much of the progress on marine gas turbines all over the world took place in design offices and engine builders' workshops, and development work was led by the British Royal Navy and other navies. While interest in the gas turbine for marine purposes, both naval and mercantile, continued to increase, the lack of availability of the results of operating experience on early gas turbine projects limited the number of new ventures on sea-going commercial vessels being embarked upon. In 1951, the diesel-electric oil tanker Auris, 12,290 deadweight tonnage, was used to obtain operating experience with a main propulsion gas turbine under service conditions at sea, and so became the first ocean-going merchant ship to be powered by a gas turbine. built by Hawthorne Leslie at Heburn on Tyne, UK, in accordance with plans and specifications drawn up by the Anglo-Saxon Petroleum Company and launched on the UK's Princess Elizabeth's 21st birthday in 1947, the ship was designed with an engine room layout that would allow for the experimental use of heavy fuel in one of its high-speed engines, as well as the future substitution of one of its diesel engines by a gas turbine. The Auris operated commercially as a tanker for 3.5 years with a diesel-electric propulsion unit as originally commissioned, but in 1951 one of its 4 824-kilowatt diesel engines, a Euro, which were known as Faith, Hope, Charity, and Prudence, was replaced by the World a Euro unregistered trademark S first marine gas turbine engine, an 890-kilowatt open-cycle gas turbo alternator built by British Thomson Houston Company in Rugby. Following successful sea trials off the Northumbrian coast, the Auris set sail from Heburn on Tyne in October 1951, bound for Port Arthur in the US and then Curacao in the Southern Caribbean, returning to Avonmouth after 44 days at sea, successfully completing her historic transatlantic crossing. During this time at sea, the gas turbine burnt diesel fuel and operated without an involuntary stop or mechanical difficulty of any kind. She subsequently visited Swansea, Hull, Rotterdam, Oslo and Southampton, covering a total of 13,211 nautical miles. The Auris then had all of its power plants replaced with a 3,910-kilowatt directly coupled gas turbine to become the first civilian ship to operate solely on gas turbine power. Despite the success of this early experimental voyage, the gas turbine was not to replace the diesel engine as the propulsion plant for large merchant ships. At constant cruising speeds, the diesel engine simply had no peer in the vital area of fuel economy. The gas turbine did have more success in Royal Navy ships and the other naval fleets of the world, where sudden and rapid changes of speed are required by warships in action. The United States Maritime Commission were looking for options to update WWII Liberty ships, and heavy-duty gas turbines were one of those selected. In 1956, the John Sargent was lengthened and equipped with a General Electric 4,900-kilowatt HD gas turbine, reduction gearing and a variable pitch propeller. It operated for 9,700 hours using residual fuel for 7,000 hours. The success of this trial opened the way for more development by GE on the use of HD gas turbines for marine use with heavy fuels. The John Sargent was scrapped in 1972 at Portsmouth, PA. Boeing launched its first passenger-carrying water jet-propelled hydrofoil Boeing 929, in April 1974. Those ships were powered by twin Allison gas turbines of the KF-501 series. Between 1970 and 1982, Seatrain Container Lines operated a scheduled container service between ports on the eastern seaboard of the United States and ports in Northwest Europe across the North Atlantic with 4 container ships of 26,000 tons DWT. Those ships were powered by twin Pratt & Whitney gas turbines of the FT4 series. The 4 ships in the class were named Euroliner, Eurofreighter, Asialiner, and Asiafreighter. Following the dramatic organization of the petroleum exporting countries' price increases of the mid-1970s, operations were constrained by rising fuel costs. Some modification of the engine systems on those ships was undertaken to permit the burning of a lower grade of fuel. Reduction of fuel costs was successful using a different untested fuel in a marine gas turbine, but maintenance costs increased with the fuel change. After 1982, the ships were sold and refitted with what at the time was more economical diesel-fueled engines, but the increased engine size reduced cargo space. The first passenger ferry to use a gas turbine was the GTS Finjet, built in 1977 and powered by 2 Pratt & Whitney Fort 4C1 DLF turbines, generating 55,000 kilowatt and propelling the ship to a speed of 31 knots. However, the Finjet also illustrated the shortcomings of gas turbine propulsion in commercial craft, as high fuel prices made operating her unprofitable. After 4 years of service, additional diesel engines were installed on the ship to reduce running costs during the off-season. The Finjet was also the first ship with a combined diesel-electric and gas propulsion. Another example of commercial usage of gas turbines in a passenger ship is Stena Line's HSS class fast craft ferries. HSS 1500 class Stena Explorer, Stena Voyager and Stena Discovery vessels use combined gas and gas setups of twin GELM 2500 plus GELM 1600 power for a total of 68,000 kilowatt. The slightly smaller HSS 900 class Stena Charisma uses twin NABE Euro STAL GT35 turbines rated at 34,000 kilowatt gross. The Stena Discovery was withdrawn from service in 2007, another victim of too high fuel costs. In July 2000, the Millennium became the first cruise ship to be propelled by gas turbines, in a combined gas and steam turbine configuration. The liner RMS Queen Mary II uses a combined diesel and gas turbine configuration. In marine racing applications, the 2010 C5000 Mystic Catamaran Miss GEICO uses two Lycoming T55 turbines for its power system. Advances in technology. Gas turbine technology has steadily advanced since its inception and continues to evolve. Development is actively producing both smaller gas turbines and more powerful and efficient engines. Aiding in these advances are computer-based design and the development of advanced materials, base materials with superior high temperature strength or thermal barrier coatings that protect the structural material from ever higher temperatures. These advances allow higher compression ratios and turbine inlet temperatures, more efficient combustion and better cooling of engine parts. The simple cycle efficiencies of early gas turbines were practically doubled by incorporating intercooling, regeneration, and reheating. These improvements, of course, come at the expense of increased initial and operation costs, and they cannot be justified unless the decrease in fuel costs offsets the increase in other costs. The relatively low fuel prices, the general desire in the industry to minimize installation costs, and the tremendous increase in the simple cycle efficiency to about 40% left little desire for opting for these modifications. On the emissions side, the challenge is to increase turbine inlet temperatures while at the same time reducing peak flame temperature in order to achieve lower NOx emissions and meet the latest emission regulations. In May 2011, Mitsubishi Heavy Industries achieved a turbine inlet temperature of 1,600 degrees Celsius on a 320-megawatt gas turbine, and 460 MW in gas turbine combined cycle power generation applications in which gross thermal efficiency exceeds 60%. Compliant foil bearings were commercially introduced to gas turbines in the 1990s. These can withstand over 100,000 start-stop cycles and have eliminated the need for an oil system. The application of microelectronics and power switching technology have enabled the development of commercially viable electricity generation by microturbines for distribution and vehicle propulsion. Advantages and disadvantages of gas turbine engines, reference for this section, advantages of gas turbine engines, very high power-to-weight ratio, compared to reciprocating engines. Smaller than most reciprocating engines of the same power rating. Moves in one direction only, with far less vibration than a reciprocating engine. Fewer moving parts than reciprocating engines. Greater reliability, particularly in applications where sustained high power output is required. Waste heat is dissipated almost entirely in the exhaust. This results in a high-temperature exhaust stream that is very usable for boiling water in a combined cycle, or for cogeneration. Low operating pressures. High operation speeds. Low lubricating oil cost and consumption. Can run on a wide variety of fuels. Very low toxic emissions of CO and HC due to excess air, complete combustion and no quench of the flame on cold surfaces. Disadvantages of gas turbine engines. Cost is very high, less efficient than reciprocating engines at idle speed, longer startup than reciprocating engines, less responsive to changes in power demand compared with reciprocating engines, characteristic whine can be hard to suppress, see also. Air start system, axial compressor, balancing machine, centrifugal compressor, distributed generation, gas turbine electric locomotive, gas turbine locomotive, gas turbine modular helium reactor, non-intrusive stress measurement system, pneumatic motor, steam turbine, turbine engine failure, Wind turbine. References. Further reading: stationary combustion gas turbines including oil and overspeed control system. Description: aircraft gas turbine technology by Owen E. Trieger, Professor Emeritus, Purdue University, McGraw-Hill, Glencoe Division, 1979, ISBN 0-07-065158-2. Gas turbine theory by H.I.H. Saravanamattu, G.F.C. Rogers and H. Cohen, Pearson Education, 2001, 5th ed., ISBN 0-13-015847-X. Liz 2, Richard A. William A. Fleming. The History of North American Small Gas Turbine Aircraft Engines. Washington, D.C., Smithsonian Institution. ISBN A1-56347-332-1A, R.M. Fred Klaas and Christopher Della Corti, The Quest for Oil-Free Gas Turbine Engines, SAE Technical Papers, No. 2006-1-3055, available at http://www.corgpapers/2006-01-3055. Model Jet Engines by Thomas Camps, ISBN 0-9510589-9-1. Traplet Publications, Aircraft Engines and Gas Turbines, 2nd edition by Jack L. Kerebrock, the MIT Press, 1992. ISBN 0-262-11162-4. Forensic Investigation of a Gas Turbine Event, 1, by John Molloy, M&M Engineering, Gas Turbine Performance, 2nd edition by Philip Walsh and Paul Fletcher, Wiley Blackwell, 2004, ISBN 978-0-632-06434-2. HTTP U Wiley.com Wiley Title Product CD 0632064-34X HTML. External links: Gas Turbine at DMOZ, New Era in Power to Turn Wheels. Popular Science, December 1939, Early Article on Operations of Gas Turbine Power Plants, Cootaway Drawings, Technology Speed of Civil Jet Engines. MIT Gas Turbine Laboratory, MIT Microturbine Research, California Distributed Energy Resource Guide, Microturbine Generators, Introduction to How a Gas Turbine Works from HowStuffWorks.com, Aircraft Gas Turbine Simulator for Interactive Learning.